Thanks for logging on to BVN8. Once again, it's your best friend, J. Cole Black, trending out here in the community with the people, finding out some more things that are going on in the community today. Before we get started, let's get who's here today. Sir, your name is?
Mike Lowe.
Gerald Givens.
Mario Salas.
City Councilman for District 2, Alan Warwick.
Okay, Councilman Warwick, in regards to today's event, it was a surprising event. People didn't see it coming. What was it all about today?
It's really all about solidarity and understanding that all lives matter, but especially black lives, because black lives have been ignored in this country, and people are killing black men throughout the country. It's not as much a problem in San Antonio, but it is still a problem in San Antonio. We have an issue with Marquise Jones here that we need to get that taken care of, and we need to move this community forward and get past this issue so we can take on the other issues that are problems for the community.
Okay. Now, Mr. Salas, I know you've been here in the community for a long time, sir, and an upstanding citizen, doing different things, a former councilman as well. Now, what have you seen transpire throughout the city of San Antonio, like the councilman said?
Well, we do have a police advisory board that we fought for a pretty long period of time. I don't think it's up to snuff. I would like to see an advisory board that has contempt and subpoena power. That was something Reverend Black always wanted and fought for all his life. So we got a while to go on that. I think we've got a police chief that wants to work with the community. We're proud of that. We got a new DA, and the new DA promised that any policeman that commits a crime, he's going to prosecute him, unlike Susan Reed, who would never prosecute anybody that was a police officer. Okay. So I think we have a change in the leadership. That looks positive. We got a change in District 2 with Mr. Warwick. We got a change with the district attorney. I think we can make some progress, but it's up to us to kind of keep that momentum going to get to realize the progress.
Okay. Now, also in regards to progress, I know that you have some very hit close to home where you're from in regards to the whole Ferguson issue and things of that nature.
That's right. I grew up in St. Louis, Missouri, and I lived a lot of my life growing up over in Ferguson, Missouri. And Mike Brown, Sr., Jr., and I all graduated from Normandy Senior High School. And so this is a very touching issue to me. Okay. And what I want to do here in San Antonio, now that San Antonio is my home, is we want to preempt.
Okay.
The police department from being like the police department in Ferguson. Okay. We want to preempt the economic and social injustices that happen in Ferguson. So what we're going to do is try our best to work with the city, work with all the business community, as well as work with the youth and create a new change and a solid San Antonio so it's a model city for the rest of America.
Right. And when it comes to a model city and coming together as a community, how strong and how important is it for the African American community and other communities as well to come together and stand for issues such as this?
It is phenomenal. At the end of the day, events like this bring the community together that is hurting to heal, brings the community together that is misinformed to educate, brings the community together that is silent to communicate. So it empowers, it enhances, and we grow as a community when we look at each other in our eyes and walk hand in hand down the streets together in solidarity.
Okay. Now, Councilman, for those who were not able to take part in today's march and in today's, showing, will there be information on Facebook? Is there a place people can check it out?
SATX4 will be the hashtag. So Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I don't know anything else. I'm still kind of old. So those are the ones that I use, and I'm definitely tagging all my pictures and videos on that. And then I'm sure Mike and Gerald will be tagging things on that as well. So SATX4 hashtag.
Okay. You heard about today from the councilman and the other representatives today and other members here of community in San Antonio. Please log on to Facebook, Instagram, and those other sites, social media, to find out more about this very trending issue and a positive issue in your community. Yes, sir.
One thing, we had all kinds of people represented here. Right. We had people from the Native American community here. You might want to talk to them before we leave. We had Mexican Americans, white women, all kinds of people. So it wasn't just a black thing. Right. It was a people thing. Mm-hmm. And I think that's very important to get across. Mm-hmm. And you might want to talk to a guy from the American Indian movement, right. Native American.
And former Councilman Salas makes a very, very, very good point that this issue isn't just an African-American issue across the nation, and it hasn't just happened recently with Ferguson. It's been going on for years to come, but now more than ever, more people are finally recognizing it and seeing what's going on.
And I can tell you a little bit about that. And growing up in Ferguson and in St. Louis metropolitan area, there are 81 different municipalities, somewhere like around that. And growing up, you could experience actually being stopped by the police 5 times in a week. And that was happening to me all the way through 16 years of age to 18 years of age. And so what happened in Ferguson, it's been brewing for a very long time, but now there's gonna be a change. Mm-hmm.
Gentlemen, thank you all today for taking the opportunity to get out in San Antonio and let people know, make them aware of what's going on and what movement you're making for not just one race, but all races and all people together. Thank you so much for logging on to this special report. This is Best Friend J. Cole. Stay logged for more. Thanks for logging on to Black Video News 8. Once again, it's Best Friend J. Cole with more of a special report. Sir, what's your name?
Antonio Diaz.
Now, Mr. Diaz, I know that you're taking part in this special march and this special togetherness today in regards to what's going on in Ferguson and in regards to what's going on across the nation. Totally. How do you feel about this, by everybody coming together for something like this?
Well, I'm a resident here of the area. I live just a block down. Okay. So as a community, I believe we have to come together on these issues of basically police abuse or police brutality against people of color,
okay,
which we all are affected by it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm proud to be here and join my community, because that's the way I see it.
Yes, sir. And moving forward, Mr. Banderas, what are some more things you want to see, I guess, in regards to the police, in regards to, you know, helping the community more? What are some things you want to see come from what just happened moving forward? What's a good direction you think that you would like to happen?
Well, that the police should be educated as far as people's civil rights, mm-hmm, and constitutional rights,
mm-hmm,
and that they are inviolate by them, that they should not violate their rights, instead of just worried about protecting corporate interest or business interest. The community is also a part of what should be protected by them,
not
be criminalized by them,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
because I see this criminal action by the police.
Okay.
Killing people and with impunity is not the way to go for our police force.
Okay.
This is not a military state or a, mm-hmm, police state.
Right.
And we will stand up and fight against that.
Right. And it's a good reason, a way to stand up to people all together, all different nationalities coming and united for more. It's your Best Friend J. Cole. Stay logged on for more.